Thank you so much. We're so happy to see you guys. I'm happy to see anybody. So let me, we all here? So is everybody here tonight? Good. Now we can proceed. So a little history first about me. My name is Roberta Donnay. I was born in Canarsie, in New York, in 1901. I was an orphan. I was found in a basket on a porch on a doorstep, wrapped in a blanket. A baby, all alone, naked. Not even a diaper. No note. Not even a bottle. We're all naked under these clothes, right? Use your imagination. Right now we're going to do a song by someone who was practically naked whenever she sang. Miss Josephine Baker.
Oh,
want to tell you a little bit more history, because I'm not supposed to be doing history as like a teacher, but I'm not really schooled, you know what I mean? Okay, so you understand. That first song, Bye Bye Blues, was written in 1925. Second song, Squeeze Me, by Fats Waller, also 1925. Sweet Georgia Brown, 1925. Mama's Got the Byron by Sippy Wallace, Miss Sippy Wallace, 1923. So in 1925, let's see, Bessie Smith was the biggest star in the world. She sold more records than any man or any dog or goldfish in the entire universe. All right, 1925, let's see, Ella Fitzgerald was 7, mm-hmm. Billie Holiday was 10, Frank Sinatra was 10, Marilyn Monroe was minus 1, and I, well, never mind, it's not about me, it's about you guys. Let's hear it for you guys, for being here. Thank you so much for supporting arts and music, especially jazz. And right now we're going to do a little song. But we have three records, three big, they're big records, but they got shrunk some. And now they look like this. But in my day, they were like these big, giant 78, you know? What is this, a 20? All right, we'll get to that later. We do have a contest coming up. It's a special Prohibition Love, 20 slang contest. It's very hard, but if you get it right, we could get one of these for absolutely zero. It will be so worth so much on the open market. I think one of these is like $50,000. Limited edition. Okay, why was I telling you that? Oh, I don't know why. Oh yeah. So this next song, a lot of these songs are on the last record called My Heart Belongs to Satchmo. And who was Satchmo? Louis Armstrong. Okay.
Thank you.
to sing along. It has something called a shout chorus. Do you ever hear this? A shout chorus in the 1920s and 30s. That means you have to shout when you say this, okay? So the first part, you're going to hear it because these guys are going to be doing it with you. Old man. Can you say that?
Old man.
Very good. The next part is we believe.
We believe.
You guys are great. Can you guys come with me on the road? To buy a lot of pizza. And then we found out.
We found out.
That's good. Okay, it's called Old Man Mose. And it came out in 1935. You know what was invented in 1935? Anybody? Canned beer. These are really important. You should take notes. Very important. I got that from Dan Hicks. I used to sing with Dan Hicks in the Hot Hicks. Not in the 70s. I wasn't born yet. I'm just kidding. No, it was later, the last 10 and a half years. Yeah. Did you know him? It's okay. I'll introduce you. All right, this is called I'm in the Market for You. This was written in 1930. I'm in the Market is about the stock market, right? It was written in 1930. But this is a love song because I'm in the market for you. It's a romantic song. Hope you like it. They've done a lot of bad things to get here. like on the way here, they were, you know, I had to pick them up. They were in the pokey, you know, last night. They knocked over a candy store. They're still holding. I mean, they take that from children. So if you're walking down the street, you want to cross the street if you see them coming towards you. Very dangerous. I guess I have to introduce them. Should I introduce you to them? You really want to? Okay. It's on you. It's on you. I have to find their names, though, because I don't know who they are. Hold on. That's a joke. I know everybody. I just don't know who I am yet. I'm trying to have a relationship. I keep breaking up with myself, not returning my own phone calls, standing myself up, you know, that kind of thing. All right. So all the way from Massachusetts? No. Where did you go?
Yeah, Massachusetts.
Massachusetts. Also known as Throw 'em in the River. Miss Carolyn Dufresne on the trombone. You should watch her. She's going to places like maybe Bellevue or something. And this guy next to her, he's a very famous guy. In the wanted posters across the towns, also known as the Lip, Pete Grimaldi on the trumpet. All the way from New York City, by way of New Jersey, Jersey. A dear, dear, dear friend of mine, until about 5 minutes ago when I found out he owes me a lot of scratch. Also known as Styx, on the drums, Dave Gibson. On piano, this person needs no introduction. All the way from New York City, by way of Oshkosh. He's gone to a lot of universities, like Sing Sing, graduated from Rikers Island, maybe. Was that recently? They let you out. Yeah. Also known as Knuckle Sandwich. Dr. E on the piano. Dr. E. The real doctor. The doctor. Got a toothache, you can come see him. And last but not least, my very, very favorite ever. But he has a huge head, swelled head, so don't say anything nice to him, because he'll just, you know, take advantage of you and your children and your grandchildren. And my grandchildren, which I haven't met yet. All right. Also known as Shotgun Bass Case, Sam Bevan on the bass. From New York City, San Francisco, and Utah. Is that right? Did I get that right? And I'm from San Francisco, except I grew up in D.C., and then I kind of hitchhiked around a lot. Okay, enough about me. Let's talk about you guys. All right, here's a song. You could sing along if you know this song, okay? I'll give you $5 if you know all the words. You might know it, though. I'm going to be broke at the end of the night.
To the sunny side of the sun.
We should start again. I saw somebody come in late. We should start all over the whole show. Yeah, okay. We're going to do a song right now about sex. Anybody have sex today? By themselves? I'm the only one. This happens all the time. I'm so embarrassed. No, I'm not. I don't really care about my personal life. I mean, I care about my personal, I don't care if you, anyway, you know what I mean. I don't care if you know about my personal life, because that's on you and your history. Okay, this is called One Monkey Don't Stop No Show. Let's hear for the women here tonight. Women, women. I can't say that enough. Women. Thank you.
He left me about 3 in the morning. I had me a man.
So what's the difference between a musician and a pizza? I'm sorry, you guys. A pizza could feed a family of four. So then Clancy told me, what if you were singing and dancing out there? I bet you could get a dime and a nickel. A whole dime. And so I sang, and it was true. I got a dime, and a dime, and a dime, and a nickel, and a nickel, and a dime, dime, nickel, nickel. My family was happy as a Larry. They were happy as a clam at high tide and gay as a $2 bill. So that's how I got here today. Yeah. Okay. No, for real, I put together the stories of all the women from back then that were singers. Josephine Baker, Ethel Waters, Bessie Smith, Ida Cox, Cynthia Walt. They all had a very similar story. In fact, they asked Ethel Waters, when she was a big, big star, what would you like if you could have anything, anything? She said, I'd like to be on a ship, or I'd like to be an assistant to a very wealthy woman. That's what was her dream. I'm like, oh my God. So anyway, that's how hard it was, right? We take a lot of things for granted, but I'm not taking it for granted. I appreciate you guys so much. So thank you again for being here. We really, really appreciate you. Thank you to the Berkshire Jazz Work. Let's hear it for them. Everybody put this together. It's a lot of work. I couldn't do it. All right. Boulevard. Should we do this one? For something completely different. The street of sorrow, the boulevard. Thank you. Children here on I'm not going to say it, sorry. It's terrible. Right. Song by Miss Sibby Wallace. Sorry, I'm not reading or anything. I have it memorized. Okay. So if you get this right, and I mean they're really, really hard, unless you, you know, study like slang. Anybody study slang in the 20s? All right. This is my life, you guys. All right. In the 1920s, what was a crate or a bucket? Just yell out if you know the answer. Who said that? Car, come on up here. That is BCD. A crate or a bucket was a car. You get to choose it. In the 1920s, what is a flat tire?
A drink?
Yell it out.
A drink.
No, it's a disappointing date. Okay, I'll just give that one to me. In the 1920s, what is a handcuff? That's close. Who said marriage? An engagement ring. Come on up. An engagement ring is a handcuff. You could take me home with you, you know what I mean? All right, this is really hard. Cash or check? In the 1920s, cash or check?
Yeah.
Do you kiss now or later? Cash or check, okay. Should I do one more? This is super easy. If you guys don't get this, then I don't know what I'm going to do. All right. What is grab some air being? Grab some air in the 1920s.
Open a window?
Now put your hands up. All right. That's okay. All right. One more. And that's it. I'm not going to do any more. I only get paid for so many, you know, by the minute. What is a century or a yard? It's $100. All right. Okay, should we do one more? Guys, I don't know. I started off so strong. What's a wrong number? Who said fella? Did somebody say fella? What? No. Not a good fella. Well, no, but not a good fella. Okay. Final. This is it. I say I don't usually give up this easily, but you know. Okay. I'm just kidding. What is kale?
Money.
Who said money first? Come on up. He won. Winner. The man who knows money right here. Let's hear for Blake. All right, am I supposed to sing? Okay. song by Bessie Smith. Thank you guys for playing that. I loved it. Because I'm wearing heels. of sick. I just have allergies that pull up. Allergies. Actually, I wrote it with him in 1923. We went to college together. You know, we were roommates. So I taught him how to play this thing called a cornet, I think. He's done a cornet, or maybe it was a... Yeah, I think he started on clarinet, maybe. Okay. Here we go with Bucket. Hope you like this. Thank you again. We love you guys.
Thank you.
preaching, you've got to like stomp your feet and scream and carry on like a crazy person. Like normally I am. You don't want to be me though. This is a song I grew up on. Judy Garland sang this song. I love Judy Garland. Do you like Judy Garland? I'm sorry, it's not from The Wizard of Oz. But I love all those songs. I think I should do an album of just those songs. Follow the Yellow Brick Road and everything like that. Okay. All right. We do have CDs in the back. Yeah, I've only bought 50,000, so there's a big discount here. I hope you like this song. Thank you so much, you guys. Thank you. Thank you.